So the ESCA, they can start, they can work with the professional and amateur or just amateur?
What do you mean? I didn't understand the question.
No, I said the ESCA, always I know the ESCA has many competitions, has many championships, but mostly from the amateurs, more than the professional, right?
It depends what you mean about professional, of course. For instance, if you look to Europe, we have some amateur events, which are tournaments, which is, most of them are not by ISCA, but this is by done by WACO, but maybe they have 10 or 11 tournaments all over Europe. But ISCA, you find them a lot in galas. A gala is an event which have about 10 to 20 fights, and there you find them everywhere. In Europe, I think the most title fights, maybe 60% title fights in Europe, are done under the ISCA rules. The bigger galas are many times done under ISCA rules because there are many. You have Bellator, you have Glory, sometimes Infusion. Many times they work together or they have to follow the ISCA rules. This is how it is.
You know, because, you know, in Arab countries, we have always, you know, because we have something is named the Arab Federation of Kickboxing. They always follow the WACO. They don't care for another organization. And they don't like this because, you know, the WACO policy always say you're not allowed to work with another association, right? That's why the Arab Federation or the Arab Kickboxing Federation, they never work with another organization like ISCA, like WBKA, like these organizations. And then for this point, the many national federation always think the WACO, no, we work just for WACO because the WACO is the biggest one in the world. The WACO maybe go to soon in the Olympic game. Another organization never do it. The WACO has big communication with another international, you know.
Sorry, okay, go ahead.
Okay, no problem. You get what I mean? You get what I mean? Yeah, that's why I always ask about this because I want to explain for the people what the difference between the ISCA and another association. I think the all organizations the same, but who's the power? Who got the power? When you go to from everywhere and you can work and you can see the branches in many countries more than one another one, right?
Okay.
There's a power.
Okay, but I think for the sport, it's the best to have one federation.
Yes.
This is the best for every sport. Football, basketball, judo, only have one big federation. This is best for the sport. The problem is now you have IFMA for Muay Thai. They are the biggest one. You can't compete with IFMA. IFMA recognized by Olympic Committee. They have the biggest fighters in the organization. But this is done only under IFMA rules. Once you go to Gala in Europe or USA or whatever, they never use IFMA rules. They will change to what we call professional rules. Even if it's not for professionals, they change the rules a little bit. And this is sometimes done under other organizations. The thing with WACO is...
Yes? So the IFMA just for amateur?
The IFMA, you have IFMA and WMC. WMC is for the professionals. But the level is very high there. If you want to be a champion on the WMC, this is the top level, the very top level. If you go to ISCA, some of them are not top level. This is also, you have some, they also do championship for B class level, which I think is not good. But this is sometimes how they earn their money, of course.
Okay, let me translate this. جماعه انا كنت بتكلم معاه على على ازاي نعرف اذا كان في المنظمه دي اكبر واحده في العالم او ان احنا ممكن نشتغل معاها او لا. وطبعا تطرقت لان الاتحاد العربي بيعمل مع الواكو وان الواكو من الاجراءات او من الشروط بتاعتها انها ما بتتيحش للاتحادات الاقليميه انها تتعامل مع اي منظمه ثانيه غيرها. فقال لي طبعا خد بالكم ان في احنا بنتكلم على حاجه في بعض المنظمات بتشتغل احتراف بس وفي بعض المنظمات بتشتغل هواه. الاسكا من المنظمات اللي بتشتغل على الجنبين، يعني بتشتغل في الهواه زي الواكو وبتشتغل في الاحتراف ولها كوميونيكيشن او علاقات مع اكثر منظمه احتراف زي الوان وزي جلوري. فبكلمه عن المواي تاي، فالمواي تاي في منظمتين، دبليو ام سي ديت دايما بتاخد الهاي ليفل يعني المستوى الاعلى من اللاعبين على المستوى الاحتراف، وفي الافما اللي هي تعتبر الاتحاد الاول للمواي تاي اللي هو يعتبر الانترناشونال فيدريشن. قال لك بس لما بيجوا يشتغلوا مع الدي ام سي الدبليو ام سي بيشتغلوا بقواعد مختلفه بيسموها على انها قواعد محترفين بتختلف عن الافما. اوكي مستر باتريك، let me ask you about you know the K1. How many round in amateur? How many round in professional? How many minute each round?
Okay, so we also have K1 with youth, which is different. So in youth, for instance, they start with 2 times 1 minute, 3 times 1 minute, 3 times 1 minute and a half. This is for youth. Youth, we mean below 16 or 17. It depends on the country. Then we go to the plus, so we call the adults. Most of them, they have, also in amateur, they have a kind of level, C-class level, new, B-class, A-class. So many times they start with 3 times 3 minutes, and then they, sorry, 3 times 2 minutes. Sometimes they go to B-class, 5 times 2 minutes, 3 times 3 minutes. And for the professionals, 3 times 3 minutes of 5 times 3 minutes. 3 times 3 minutes is the most they do for the moment now, because they can put more more fighters in one show. That's why they use the 3 times 3. I prefer the 5 times 3 minutes because I think you will have better athletes. But this, of course, it depends on the promoter. It's the promoter who decides.
Okay, جماعه بكلموا على الجولات ووقت الجولات في الكي 1. فقال لك وفي مستويين، مستوى اللي تحت ال 60 وال 70. فطبعا ده بيبقى ممكن دقيقه في ثلاث جولات في دقيقه او ثلاث جولات في دقيقه ونص، او اذا كان في الاتجاه الثاني الجزء الثاني اللي هو بتاع الادلت اللي هو الراشدين او الكبار. يعني ساعات في بعض الدول التابعه للبروموتر اللي بينظم الحدث بيعمل دقيقتين جول، ثلاث جولات في دقيقتين او ثلاث جولات في 3 دقائق او 5 جولات في دقيقتين. ديت بترجع للبروموتر اللي بينظم الحدث، ودايما اللي بيشتغل دلوقتي 3 جولات في 3 دقائق عشان يحط فيها اكتر عدد من اللاعبين الفايترز، فبيعمل شيء من الاثاره، فبتبقى مقبوله اكتر للناس خاصه للمنظمين والسبونسر اللي بيدفعوا فيها. اوكي يو نو ان ان كي 1 ذا كي 1 ان ايجيبت اند عرب كانتري وي جاست ستارتد لايك 6 7 8 years ago or maybe more than 10 years before this. We never use it. We use something is named Oriental, and before the Oriental was the low kick.
Yes, this was what we called kickboxing then.
Yes, that's before. Yeah, this before in the same like 10 years ago in Europe, just like this with the same rules, with the same start with the K1.
Before you had, like you said, you had the kickboxing, you had the full contact with the long trousers.
Yes.
This is Wako system, very much Wako system. Then you had the kickboxing, but no knees.
Low kicks. Low kicks,
you know. And you had the small shoes you had to put on your feet.
Yes.
This was the kickboxing, and then you had Thai boxing.
Mm-hmm. That's before, suddenly, right?
That was before. And suddenly K1 appeared in Japan, and everybody went to do K1. Mm-hmm. That time K1 was worldwide very popular, so they made the changement, which was very good, because you had some Muay Thai federations, you had some kickboxing federation, and in K1 style they can mix, they can find each other on a rule which is for both of them, I think, very good. So you can have the best athletes, of course not in their own style, but this was the beginning. Now you have people who only train K1, so now I think the K1 athletes who are only trained K1 should be better than the one before, because before they trained many different styles.
So now we have a different fighters. Just the people who they like the K1, they never tried the other styles. But before, the same fighter can play with everything. The any style. I did it before. Yeah. I did it before in the Egyptian national team. I went the World Championship in Beirut, in Lebanon, and then I used to have the two fighters. Each one played the full contact and the low kicks in the same time. Okay. جماعة احنا بنتكلم على الاساليب بتاع اسلوب الكي 1. احنا ابتدينا تقريبا في الوطن العربي بنمارسه او بندخله في الايفنتات عندنا يمكن من 10 سنين. فكان في الاول في الاسلوبين المعروفين، كان هو الفول كونتاكت واللو كيكس. واللو كيكس ده كان بيتقال عليه كيك بوكسنج. اللو كيكس ده كان بالشورت، تمام، وكان الفول كونتاكت طبعا بالبنطلون، وكان معروفه ايامها اللي هي التاي بوكسنج وخلاص. لكن في الوقت الحالي، وكان اللاعب كان ممكن يلعب باللو كيكس والفول كونتاكت زي ما احنا كنا بنقول ومشاركاتنا، وكان ممكن يبقى بعضهم بيحب يلعب تاي بوكس. في الوقت الحالي بقى كله بيفضل الكي 1 لانها اكثر حماسيه واكثر اكسايتنج دلوقتي. ويمكن بعض المنظمات العالميه على مستوى الاحتراف والهواه بتستخدم الكي 1، وفي الوقت الحالي اللي بيلعب كي 1 ما بيحبش يلعب حاجه ثانيه. ده مستر باتريك، ده اي سو ذس بيفور، لايك يو سيد the last 5 years the fighter who do who like the K1 they never like the other styles because they think no I'm professional K1 so he don't like to move to another style like the four contact. And this happened with me 2017 in the Arab Federation with the Arab Championship. So جماعه في اسئله حد حبيت تسالوها؟ وان سكند مستر.
ايوه يا دكتور معاك.
في اسئله حابين تسالوها؟
معاك يا دكتور هسالها. يا مستر هاي مستر باتريك هاو ار يو؟ وزيو حماد
هاو يو؟
حماد عبد الغني وزيو. All fighters in Arab countries and especially Egypt like to make have fight a professional fight with great fighters is world champion, like world champion, but they not have any chance to have this fight with world champion.
I ask you, Mr. Patrick, how I get the chance to be a professional fighter?
Okay. Yeah. First of all, it's not that easy because you have to be good level. So I think you need to have a lot of amateur fights before you can go to another level. A lot of amateur fights is not 10 or 20, but 30, 40 before you can go to another level. Also, the difference between some countries, the level is very different. If you go to Western Europe, the K1 level is very high, generally speaking. If you go to some other countries, the K1 level is lower. So this can be a difference. If you want to fight to a Dutch fighter or a French fighter, you must be sure you have the same level. Otherwise, it's not a good fight. I only like a fight who is very clean, have the same level. So now how can you become a professional? It depends, of course, of the country. You need promoters to organize professional fights. If you don't have promoters, you can only do amateur fights. So this is the first step. Do a lot of good promotions. From there on, start inviting some more higher level fighters so that your own fighters from Egypt can grow. Don't let the first time get the best fighters in the world to fight the Egyptian fighter. Take your time because you have to develop your sport and you need to have your own good athletes. This is very important. Once you have a certain level, then you can try to fight for Arabic championship or world championship. But this, of course, takes some time. And to be on the top, you don't only have to be on the best one, but you only need a good manager. Once you go to the professional, a good manager is very important because it's a manager who can have the contact to get you the professional fights, to get you to the world title fights. This is maybe not good, but this is how this world works for professional fighters. So a good manager is very important.
So the manager and promoter, he has the connection with another promoters. That's why he can take you and move you. You make like a motivation from the amateur to professional fighters. هو يا جماعه بيتكلم اولا ان لازم تكون مستواك انت
حاسس. السؤال الاول يا دكتور اللي السلبي.
السؤال احنا بنقول له ازاي تبقى انت لاعب محترف هواه وعايز تنتقل للاحتراف. تمام؟ فهو بيقول ان اولا المستوى اللي انت بتلعب فيه عشان تبقى حاسس ان انت تقدر تطلع من مستوى اللي هو لازم تكون اولا لعبت مباريات كتير وحسيت ان انت بقيت متميز وتفضل تدور على اللاعبين المميزين في الهواء عشان تقدر تفوز عليهم وتعمل نفسك ريكورد زي ما انت كنت بتتكلم يا كابتن حمد امبارح. فبقول لك هو من اهم العناصر في التحول من اللي هو الاحتراف، البروموتر او المانجر اللي بيتعامل معاك، اللي بيظبط، اللي بينظم الاحداث ويقدر ياخدك من الحدث الهواه ويؤهلك للحدث المحترفين. فانا بقول له طب هو ما يعني الافضل ان يكون في بروموتر او المانجر اللي بيدير تنظيم الحدث؟ قال لك لان هو اللي بقى عنده علاقات مع المنظمين التانيين ويقدر يحطك من مكان لمكان اعلى، من مستوى الهواه لمستوى الاحتراف. كمل يا كابتن محمد دلوقتي.
تمام. بالنسبه مستر باتروك، امتى يقدر يجي ان مصر المصري يدي يحاضر في محاضره عمليه في المستقبل ان شاء الله؟
حماده اسك يو وين يو كان وي جيت ذا تشانس تو كم تو ايجيبت اند جوين اس وز ذا بيجست سيمينار فور ذا ايجيبشن اند عرب ترينر.
That's no problem. I would like to come to Egypt. So the more the sport is developed, the better for the sport, because we need everybody in the whole world to be on a certain level. We need to help each other. Maybe today this country is better, but maybe tomorrow the other country will be better. Yeah. Egypt is a big country. You have many youth, many youth. You have many people eager for training. So I think kickboxing, K1 style, Thai boxing, other martial arts are very good for this, for your youth. So the more youth you have, the better trainers you have. A certain moment, all the other countries will also see that Egyptian is on the level is growing. Once they see this, they will start inviting Egyptian fighters. Maybe in the beginning they will lose, but at the end, I'm sure that Egyptian fighters will come to fight and not to take the money. So at the end, promoters will see, oh, this is interesting. Why not we take some Egypt fighters to Europe as well?
هو عموما هو يتمنى انه يجي مصر، وبيتكلم ان مصر بلد كبيره وفيها فرصه ان يطلع فيها لاعبين كتير كويسين ومتميزين في اكثر من ستايل زي الكيك بوكسنج وفول كونتاكت والكي 1. بس انا اعتقد يعني برضو ان السؤال يعني يمكن سابق لاوانه شويه حماد، عشان الظروف اللي احنا فيها والحظر
تمام
منع الطيران وكده. لكن هو يتمنى، وبيقول ان احنا عندنا فرص كتيره جدا اذا كان مصر او الدول العربيه نتيجه عدد السكان ممكن يطلع منهم فرص كويسه قوي. والله انا شايف الحل ان احنا ممكن نوجد البروموتر والمانجرز في الدول بتاعتنا عشان تقدر تخرج اللاعبين من المكان ده للمكان ده.
ما عشان عن طريق اللي هم يقولنا يجوا كدورات كده. طب يا دكتور، السؤال الثاني، السؤال الثاني، ايه اللي بينصحه للاعب الكي 1 في المباريات؟ ايه النصائح يعني اللي يعطيها للاعب الكي 1 في المباريات او الصفات المميزه له يكون لاعب كويس؟
مستر باتريك، what your advice to the K1 fighters in the ring and before the ring? On the ring and before the ring. Your advice.
Your advice. You mean if they want to start fighting?
Yeah, you know the fighter, the K1 fighters. And when they go to the competition, what do you advise now before they go to the competition? And then who was on the ring? What you can give him the advice? Relaxation, okay, or be like smart? What you can think?
Okay. First of all, it's important that the trainer and the fighter should be one team. This is very important. Sure. So most of the gyms, and I think all the Egyptian trainers as well, you get some youths, 12, 13, 14, 15, and you train them for 4, 5, 6 years before they have to fight. So
at the moment, you're...
Okay.
بقول له
اعرفه يعني اتكلم شويه. اوكي اي ويل ترانسليت تو يو ستيب باي ستيب، ذاتس واي اسك مي اباوت.
اوكي.
هو بيتكلم على ان اللاعب والمدرب لازم يكون وان تيم، يعني جسد واحد او فريق واحد مع بعض يعني. اوكي.
اوكي. سو يو جاست لايك ا كايند اوف فادر. سو ذس مينز يو نو هاو ذا فايتر when he will be ready. This is very important. The trainer has المدرب. to be 100% sure that the fighter will be ready.
المدرب زي الاب لازم يكون عارف ان اللاعب جاهز للمباراه قبل ما ياخدوا المباراه. اوكي.
Okay. And the fighter also must know that he is ready. If the fighter has any doubt, you can't send him in the ring. It doesn't
نفس
matter.
الحكايه بالنسبه للاعب، لازم يكون هو مؤمن بنفسه ومقتنع اذا كان جاهز او لا. اوكي.
Once you lose this, the chemical between the fighter and the trainer, it's over. The trainer always is the boss.
الموضوع بيعتبر معقد او صعب جدا، ويعتبر يعني منتهي لو كان الحكايه اذا اسمها الهارموني او الكيميكال، الكيمياء اللي بين المدرب واللاعب لو مش موجوده، ان يكون المدرب حاسس باللاعب واللاعب حاسس بالمدرب، لو مش موجوده ديت يبقى في خساره، في هزيمه. اتفضل. يس.
Okay, it's very important that the fighter must understand and the trainer as well. We don't play football, we do a fight sport. This means once you get in the ring, even if you win, you will get hurt. This is yes. number one. If you only go to the ring to enjoy, never go inside the ring. You can enjoy, but not the same like playing football.
لازم يكون في تكامل يا جماعه وتوحد بين اللاعب والمدرب، وان المدرب عارف ان اللاعب ده جاهز عشان ياخدوا المباراه، واللاعب نفسه لازم يكون مؤمن انه جاهز ويقدر يخش المباراه. بقول لك انت بتلعب فايت يعني قتال، مش بتلعب مثلا ماتش كوره، انت المفروض ان انت تكون عارف ان انت جاهز انك تروح، فبالتالي لما انت تكون جاهز ما انتش راح تستمتع، انت راح تلعب فايت. خد بالك انك ممكن تكون فايز بس تحصل عندك دامج او اصابات نتيجه ان انت مش مستوعب حجم ان انت رايح تلعب فايت مع على حلقه. اوكي.
Okay. Once the fight starts, so then it's up to the fighter. You can't help the fighter. The thing you can help the fighter is between the rounds. Between the fight, you can call to the fighter, you can call whatever you want, or he doesn't hear it, which is sometimes normal. People who used to fight, they know you can't hear because you're in a tunnel, like the tunnel. You don't know what's happening. But as a trainer, sometimes you look from a different angle. So these things you can use between the rounds to adapt your fighter, maybe to change his tactics or to be careful for this or for that. This is the only things I think you can do between the rounds.
Okay. هو عموما هو بيتكلم برضه على حاجه احنا اتكلمنا عليها في الدوره اللي فاتت، لما قلنا ان النصايح والتوجيه بتاع المدرب للاعب بيكون ما بين الجولات بس، لانك انت ممكن تقعد تصرخ للاعب وتوجهه وهو في الحلقه بيلعب بس هو مش مستوعبك اصلا، كانك داخل في نفق فمستمع حاجه. اللاعب بيبقى في المباراه مش مستوعب غير ان هو بيعمل ايه، وبعدين انت ممكن توجهه وتقول له الصح انت عملته والغلط انت عملته، ده ما بين الجولات مش اكتر. هو ده التوجيه اللي ممكن يقوله للاعب على الحلقه. اوكي.